after the presentation of the all-new SEAT Leon, actually 3 weeks ago, just 3 weeks ago, today we are marking the second anniversary of our special car brand with the inauguration of the Cupra Garage and the reveal of the first Cupra Leon family in both streets and racing versions. Tonight, you will have the possibility to visit the new Cupra's operations center, but where we are standing now is the Cupra Racing Factory. So the Cupra Racing Factory is the brand's motorsport facilities, which has been completely redeveloped to house the production of future racing cars, as well as to host the development of special series and the individualized treatment of some models and accessories. So, in a few minutes, Cupra experts will walk you through this new path that Cupra is creating in the automotive world. But to explain the role of Cupra within the SEAT organization, please welcome on stage SEAT President Carsten Isensee.
Good evening and welcome everyone. It's an honor to be here with you at such an important milestone for Cupra. The day we are inaugurating the brand's new facilities with the reveal of its upcoming street models and racing cars. After a month as SEAT president, I have had the chance to present you the fourth generation of the SEAT Leon. And this evening I have the pleasure to be present at the reveal of the king of the family, the Cupra Leon. And I can't complain. It is a good time to be part of this company here. 2 years ago, we took a big step establishing Cupra as a standalone brand, testing the competences, the capabilities, and the potential of our organization. And it couldn't have worked better because in this short time, Cupra has become our most profitable business unit. SEAT and Cupra have a natural bond. SEAT gives Cupra the base to grow, and Cupra gives SEAT the opportunity to move to more profitable models and reach different customer groups. Their paths are synergetic, and the two brands give us the resources and the operational base to develop and grow. We believe both SEAT and Cupra are in a good position to make the most of this momentum. Today, we are empowering the Cupra brand by opening its new headquarters for its dedicated organization. And in the short term, Cupra will launch its own models like the Cupra Formentor, which will take the brand to a new level. Moreover, we count with the full endorsement of the Volkswagen Group and its chairman, Dr. Diess, who visited our new facilities last week. To further explain you these bright results and our plans ahead, I will leave you with the leader of this tribe, Cupra CEO and Vice President for Sales and Marketing SEAT, Wayne Griffiths. But before we want to show you how this story started, just a second. Thank you.
Of people rather than machines and numbers.
This is a story of people who love what they do. And
the more experienced and obsessed among us who went back to the garage to build a contemporary vision of sportiness,
Something that has less to do with lap time and more to do with enjoying the moment. Something rare, not exclusive. They are the ones who will transform the concept of racing. They will take it to the streets by joining forces with those who share their mindset on how to create electric experiences. They are the people who will create a world around performance and invite you to it. It's a world of aspiration, a place where you don't need luxury to feel unique. They will come together as one, driven by the same values and ambitions, bringing to life special cars for special people.
Hi, everybody. It's great to have you all here this evening. Thank you, Carsten, for your welcome. Also from my side, a real warm welcome. A real special day for Cooper today. It was, I think, almost to the day 2 years ago when we decided to launch a new brand, the Cooper brand in Terramar. We were all full of passion, full of energy. But at the time, there were a lot of people around who had their doubts. A lot of doubters, even people, some of the people thought we were even crazy what we were doing, trying to create a new brand in a moment of the industry where brands were consolidating. Back then, we had big dreams with only a few believers, but I think that even a few believers can make big dreams come true. And these believers, over the last 2 years, have taken Cooper up further and faster than we could have ever thought or we ever expected. We're really proud of the results that Cooper is achieving. Last 2 years, we sold, since we launched the brand in Cooper Terramar, we sold 40,000 Coopers around the world. 2019 was our record year, 25,000 cars sold, 70% more than the year before. And this performance, obviously, is not only driven by this few believers, this fantastic team of people working at Cooper, but also about the fantastic cars, and the Cooper Ateca. We launched it, and in the first year, we achieved 10,000 sales, 10,000 Cooper Ateca. And the big surprise for us last year probably was the Leon. The Leon, in the final year of its life cycle, set a new record, and we sold 15,000 Leon. Now, looking at our markets, our biggest market, number one market for Cooper is Germany. In Germany, Bernhard Bauer and the team, they're doing an excellent job selling 10,000 cars last year. Germany then followed by the UK market, by our home market, Spain, Switzerland, France, and Austria. In Mexico, we're particularly happy about the Cooper results, a great market for Cooper. In Mexico, one third, so every third Leon we sell is a Cooper. And last year, we had the real pleasure of opening our first Cooper garage worldwide in Mexico City, and that was a great step for us in Mexico. But not only in terms of sales is Cooper doing a great job, it's also doing a great job financially. As Carsten Isensee said in his introduction, Cooper is key in moving up Seat's center of gravity with higher transaction prices and more emotional cars. The Cooper mix within the overall Seat portfolio continues to grow, with an Ateca now selling 15% of all Atecas are Cooper Ateca. And in the case of the Leon, 10% of all Leons we now sell are Cooper Leons. Cooper is becoming more and more important part of Seat and our overall business. We plan in a very short term of time to achieve 1 billion euro of turnover. That's within our reach. When we launch the Cooper Leon, we believe we will be making around 1 billion euro turnover with the Cooper business, within the whole Seat business, around 10% of our whole business. Now, back in Terramar, we announced an ambitious goal, or lots of ambitious goals. We said we would extend our product range, we would triple our mix, but we would double our volume within 2 years. And I'm proud to say that that is what we have achieved. The result, as I said, is obviously driven by these great products on the product offensive. And now it is time to prove that this performance that the Coopers deliver can be electrified. We believe that electrification and sportiness are a perfect match. And starting our electric product offensive will be three plug-in hybrid performance hybrid versions in the Cupra range. The Cupra Leon 5-door as a performance hybrid, the Cupra Leon Sports Tourer, as you will see both cars here today, and another car, the Cupra Formentor, where you will still have to wait a little bit because we'll be showing you that in Geneva in 2 weeks' time. So we're always looking for ways to make our products better. Also doing that with external partner. And one of our key partners in doing that is APT, developers of racing and tuning components for street use. I'm really happy that the guys from APT, Hans-Jürgen APT, and the guys from APT are here with us tonight for this event. We started our cooperation at the very beginning, in mid-2018, as we were setting out with Cupra. Our first development was on a Leon. And together, we create extreme performance cars, or you create out of our car extreme performance cars, with, for instance, the 350-horsepower version of the Cupra Ateca, which is available in key markets such as Germany, Switzerland, Austria, and UK. And we did around 300 of these very, very special Ateca powered by APT. And with APT, we're looking together to doing cool stuff together in the future on upcoming models, on the Cupra Leon, Cupra Formentor. I think we have a lot of potential, but also looking forward to working with the guys from APT in the motorsport area with our e-racer. Looking back to Terramar, we said our strategy had three pillars. The products, which I've already spoken about a lot, and which I think we really are delivering on a special distribution network, and on the brand. In terms of distribution, back then we had a big job of trying to set up a dealer network specialized on Cupra, and I have to say we've made great progress in this area. We've established, I think, around 240 Cupra specialists around the world. And these Cupra specialists will be employing Cupra masters who will deliver a specific customer experience focused on the whole customer journey, not just on the sales, but also on the after sales. We are creating Cupra garages, like the one I said in Mexico. And these Cupra garages will grow around the world as Cupra grows. And the key experience here will be digital, it will be an online experience, but also what will stand out is the human touch aspect. In terms of branding and collaborations, here we've also been really active. We said Cupra should not only be a car brand, but a brand with a bigger ecosystem, so we've been really busy here, working and collaborating with lots of different companies from Barcelona. We wanted something that authentic, that fits with us. One of the first projects we started with was a Masset. A Masset lamps from Barcelona. For me, some of the most beautiful design lamps that you can find. But we didn't want to just do merchandising with them, take the product and brand it Cupra. We decided together with Masset to design a specific lamp. Our designers and the lamp designers from Masset, so car designers and lamp designers from Masset, to design a specific lamp that I think you can see here, the Chispa, that will be going to the market now under the Cupra name together with Masset. We also work together with Masset in our Cupra garages in our network, and you'll also see later in the garage headquarter building that Masset did the lighting here. And I'm really happy that Javier Masset has decided to join us here today. Thanks for being here, Javier, and Joan Miró, the commercial director as well. So regarding fashion, yeah, we're working with lots of different companies. We're working with LGR on sunglasses, but we're now even creating our own leather jackets, which we'll see later. We also took a new partner in the footwear area, Mikakos, a brand from Barcelona like us. And talking about partnerships, We also went into partnerships in sport with a very emerging sport, with paddle. Paddle is growing in popularity, has become the second most widely practiced sport in Spain, and is currently the fastest growing sport in Europe. We support the World Paddle Tour, and I'm really happy tonight to welcome four brand ambassadors from the world of paddle: Fernando Belasteguin, Pablo Lima, Alejandra Salazar, and Ariana Sanchez. Thanks for being here today. However, our biggest partnership in the area of sport, obviously, has been our decision to partner with Barca. Our discussions about coming partners with Barcelona happened middle of last year. We're very fast. We really got to an agreement very, very quickly. And we agreed on one thing, that we were not interested, neither was Barca nor us, interested in a sponsorship. Okay, it would help Cupra with awareness, but we said we need a partnership. We wanted to do more than just the branding and the co-branding. So I think we found out very quickly that we share very similar goals, or the same goal, trying to inspire the world from the fantastic city of Barcelona. We agreed that we would provide mobility solutions for Camp Nou Stadium, and also provide the possibility, but not as a must, only for those who want to drive the Cupra cars within the organization and the players. And I'm really happy that the guy from Barca who persuaded me then that it was a great idea, that Xavi Asensi is with us here today. Xavi, it was a great idea. Thanks for making our partnership with Barcelona happen. FC Barcelona is helping to expand the Cupra Drive with an elite team of believers whose ambition will place Cupra, I believe, in another league. And tonight, we make a really big step forward by welcoming a new member of the Cupra tribe, a great sportsman who has become an example of passion and determination throughout his professional career, Marc ter Stegen. So, Marc, great to have you with us here tonight. Great that you could have the time. Marc and me, I was going to say we met the first time 5 months ago at Cupra, but we met before in another life as well with another brand. But when we met, Marc came and spent the whole afternoon with us in design, together with Alejandro Misonero, because we wanted to persuade the guy that the Cupra was the right brand for him. We were quite sure he would be the right personality for us, and I think we had a great day there, Marc, and I remember you were particularly impressed, I think, by the Cupra Formentor and top plug-in hybrid.
Thanks, Wayne. First of all, yes, exactly this. When I came here just to get to know the brands, I came with a neutral, open mindset, and I wanted to discover what's your plans, what is your project for the future, and I'm very happy that you got me into the world of Cupra, and now I'm standing here having a great partnership now with you, and I'm really looking forward to what's coming. The coming projects will be amazing, and well, when I was here, of course there's also the relation to Barcelona, to the city. You made me feel really comfortable. It was not just the partnership, it was also a feeling I had when I came here for the first time, and it's also this exactly what makes me think about the brands and me and my passion, my mindset, and I think we have something in common, And this is why I decided to be, I wanted to be one of you. And I'm very happy that it's possible.
So welcome to the Cooper tribe. Your Cooper Formentor plug-in hybrid, the one you really want, is going to take a while. But till the end of the year, you should be able to have it. I know you're already a member of the tribe because you've got your bracelet. So we both have the bracelet. But I thought, okay, what can we give you tonight? Okay, you're going to be driving your Cooper Ateca, a limited edition, until the Cooper Formentor is here. But to really make you, part of the tribe, you're the first guy to get our exclusive new leather jacket from Cooper. I hope you wear it, and I hope it fits you.
Sure.
But I bet it looks a lot better on you than it does on me. Thank you. Thanks, Mark.
Thank you.
So moving from the sport of football to the world of motorsport. Motorsport and racing, car racing, has always been part of Cupra's DNA, an important part of our DNA. Cupra stands for Cup Racing. That's where the name came from. And back at Terramar, we showed a dream back then of creating an electric touring car, the e-racer, an example of the capabilities of the brand of Cupra, particularly in the electric age. As I said, I believe that Cupra shows that electrification and performance are a great combination. And I can announce tonight that finally, after 2 years almost of discussions, that we will take part in the World Electric Touring Car Championship as presented yesterday in Paris under the title of Pure ETCR. We will be taking part in that. And our race drivers and brand ambassadors, Matthias Ekström, Rally Cross and DTM champion, and Jordi Genet, World Touring Car champion, will explain more about racing and our products. But before that, let's see them both in the Cupra racing cars.
What is it that drives us forward every day? To reinvent the race car of the future. A car to set new standards in racing. To expand this vision together with those who share our passion. To take racing to new places and rethink the way we experience it. It's going to be exciting.
Hello, good evening from my side. Cupra is pioneering once again in racing world, and tonight we are going to present the link between racing cars and street. And the best way to do that is thanks to the Cupra León competition. Well, as you can see, it's a car that has improved aerodynamic efficiency. We have more downforce, and we also managed to get less drag. We managed to also to reduce the weight in order to have lighter suspension components with better kinematics. And with this, we managed also to reduce this inertia that we have on the car. So we have a better weight distribution. About the engine, we have a new 2-liter turbo engine with 340 horsepower and 410 newton meter torque. That give us a very good acceleration and through the whole range of RPMs. And all the electronics are made in-house with our engineers just nearby. So this gives us very good performances. We have a 260 kilometer per hour top speed, and the acceleration from 0 to 100 is around 4.5 seconds. So I can say that we have a car that is ready to compete in the upcoming TCR championships. And believe me, I'm sure with a very, very good results. So now that's about that car. Matthias, can you tell us about the electric racing cars?
Sure. Good evening, everybody. Pleasure to see so many of you here. The first 100% electric Cupra race car is also with us here tonight. So please welcome the new Cupra e-racer. This car has 680 horsepower, nearly 1,000 newton meter of torque. It does 0 to 100 in 3.2 seconds, 0 to 200 in 8.2 seconds, and a top speed of 270. For me, this is a lot of impressive facts, and I think it's cool. Remember, it's rear-wheel drive. While electric power is going to be one of the core pillars for Cupra's motorsport activities, all the engineers at Cupra have been developing this car so that we will have to transmit the completely new experience to the racetrack. Yesterday, I was in Paris and for the presentation of the new Pure ETCR series. First, this year, we will do some demo races and some promotion. And later on, we will also go racing in 2021, where it will be 8 races. I must say, I'm really excited to be part of this. And the first event we will go is in Goodwood, in the famous hill climb in the middle of July. And after, there will also be some other events. And especially excited I am to team up with you as a teammate, Jordi.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
As we both have a lot of experience from the racetracks over the years, we would like to try and bring this knowledge to the street. And as Wayne requested that we should try and get this knowledge into the new Cupra Leon, we have done our best. And now we will show you a little video from this. And enjoy it and see you later.
We've been able to define improvements on the steering calibration to make it even more precise without getting too heavy.
I suggest making the car even more aggressive and reactive in the first part of the corner. And I bet you to have it implemented for the next test.
The gear shift on the new Cupra Leon is a lot faster. Now the reaction time is a lot better.
The calibration of DCC suspension of the chassis can be a bit more aggressive.
Thank you, Matthias. Thank you, Jordi. I think these guys' feedback at an early stage on the development of the Cupra Leon were really key. I think particularly their inputs around how fast the DSG needs to be have had an impact. When I drove the car for the first time a week ago, that the DSG now is a lot faster. We have a really fast DSG, which for me on the previous car was always a thing that something that we could improve. And I think what Jordi was talking about as well, the stiffness and of the suspension and the whole chassis, because the Cupra is bigger, will make the car really sporty as well. So the Leon is a really big car for Cupra. It's our key, one of our key pillars. We've sold 44,000 Leon Cupras in this last generation of the Leon, and it's been the best seller in the Cupra range. So I think it was a difficult job for our engineers, for Axel Andorf and all the team there. It was a difficult job for them to come up with an even better car. But I believe the team has achieved that and done an excellent job. And tonight, we continue the success story of the model, strengthening the Cupra whole Cupra brand. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage the new Cupra Leon, or as I prefer to call it, the King of Leons. So I hope you agree I didn't overpromise the new Cupra Leon, whether it's a sports tourer or the Cupra Leon five door here as a hybrid version, is what I said, the king of Leons. A car with a stunning design, whether sports tourer or the five door in particular for me. A very difficult job, I think, of Alejandro Misionero and his team to come up with an even better design for the Cupra Leon, but I've done that. I think it's a lot more original Cupra and a much more Cupra DNA in the design. Inspired by the racetrack and our race drivers, I said before. Also, for the first time now, we're plug-in hybrids, the three plug-in hybrids across the whole range, the plug-in hybrids in both of these cars. And big technical improvements in terms of a stiffer chassis and the faster DSG. There's a lot more to talk about with the car, a lot more detail, but I think our team of experts are in a better position to do that. I'm sure they can explain it a lot better than I can. So I'd like to now welcome on stage Chief Operating Officer of Cupra, the head of the tribe, Antonino Labate, Marta Alumni, Chief Technical Officer of the Cupra tribe, and Francesca Sangalli, who did the fantastic color and trim on this car. Come up, guys, and ladies. So I leave it to you.
Good evening, everyone, also from our side. Our Cupra Leon represents the ultimate expression of Cupra contemporary performance. It's a car created for those people who are centered, understand and know exactly what they do and don't like. Our main objective with this King of Leon is to reach those people who are challenge-oriented with a special taste for car and don't need to ask for permission or recognition. The unique character of our King of Leon is based on its striking design, its outstanding driving performance, and its contemporary performance.
The Cupra Leon has a very distinctive exterior and with a bold design. In the front, you have a sculptural wing and a bumper with dominant air intakes and a grille with a symmetric pattern following and integrating the logo. At the back, you have prominent exhaust pipes that really highlight the character, the sporty character of the car. The dark chrome that you find that in several details in the exterior of the car is has a shiny effect, a shiny finish, in contrast with the matte and very stony finish of the body. The copper is as a strong brand ID material for Cupra, is the only chromatic accent in the exterior of the car. You find it in the logo and in the wheels, in the alloy wheels, and is really giving this progressive and sophisticated feel.
One of the main focus during the development of the first Cupra Leon has been the definition of its chassis. As I like to say, it defines the soul of the car. We wanted the Cupra Leon to offer an outstanding driving experience. We have done it. The car is very precise and has an exceptional dynamism. We have achieved this goal by making a stiffer body compared to the previous Leon Cupra. On the other hand, the lower ground clearance, of course, makes the car even more stable on the road. As a driver, you will surely enjoy the optimized reaction that the gear change is offering.
In the interior of the Cupra Leon, you find features inspired by our racing car, like the bucket seat and the steering wheel with the selectors and the mode selector and the start engine buttons, and the digital cockpit with the sporty view. Everything there is really to emphasize the sporty character of the car. But sportiness here is combined with sophistication. So when you are inside the cabin, you are surrounded somehow by a mix of materials that really deliver this sense of well balance and rich, you know, interior. So, so basically, you are you find the dark chrome precious details and brush surfaced and like refined stitched in the leather of the seat and the door and the door panels. Copper also in the interior is the highlight. So you find it in like a special touch in the steering wheel stitches and as a frame for the vents.
The engine of the car, as the heart of a human being, supplies rhythm and pace. In the Cupra León, we introduce electrification for the first time in our engine portfolio. The high-performance plug-in hybrid delivers 245 horsepower with an all-electric range up to 60 kilometers, thanks to his 13 kilowatt-hours battery pack. The Cupra León makes electrification meet performance. The wide range of engines with DHT transmission is completed by the well-known 2-liter TSI, with three power outputs, 245 and 300 horsepower in front-wheel drive, and the most powerful 310 horsepower, only available in the Sports Tourer with four-drive technology.
Yeah, well, after your fantastic detailed technical description, it's now time to highlight the main purchase reason from our unique customer at Cupra. These are outstanding driving experience, contemporary performance, striking design, high level of comfort, state-of-art technology, and for the first time, a wide range of engines. The car will be available at the end of this year in all European markets. To summarize, our Kinga León is the perfect car for those people who are driving lovers, open to electrification, seeking for fun and performance. Thank you very much.
So, Cupra León, the king of Leons, well done, all three of you, for explaining our fantastic new Cupra León range. And the Cupra León is only a next step on our journey with Cupra, a journey with the brand. And as we showed you last year, the Cupra Formentor will come into series, and will come into series like we presented the show car during this year. And we'll premiere in Geneva Motor Show in less than 2 weeks. A big step for Cupra, the Cupra León, I think probably one of the most important cars for the Cupra future. A car purely designed and developed for the Cupra brand on its own. And my head of press, Christian Stein, didn't want me to show the car tonight. He wouldn't let me show it because he said he wanted to still keep some things to keep you guys excited to look ahead for. So I'm not allowed to show you the car, but this video behind may give you an insight, a feeling of what's to come. So we've talked a lot about product, about brand strategy, racing, and exciting things that will be happening at Cupra. But for me personally, the biggest thing that I'm experiencing on this journey, fantastic journey with Cupra, is the people behind the scene, the Cupra tribe. And you've met some of them here tonight. We've been really busy over the last couple of years putting a team of people together. We made the decision to have a separate organization outside of SEAT for Cupra, for them to be faster, to be more creative, to be braver with their ideas. We've increased the amount of people working on Cupra from 100 to 200 people. And therefore, we thought now is the right time to give this tribe of people, this tribe of believers, the rightful home and rightful place for them to work in. Tonight, as Christian explained, we're in the racing factory. The racing factory is where we will develop and produce racing cars, of course, but also where our engineers, Marta and the rest of the engineers, will be working on the series models too. The Cupra garage that you will see later in the evening is where the other functions are. My office, I'm looking to have an office there, together with the other core areas of sales and marketing, product marketing, finance, purchasing and production. We will have a whole team of people working there, and we will show you that tonight. A place where, as I said before, things can happen fast with a motivated team prepared to fight and turn that into reality, their big dreams. 2,400 square meters, not a traditional office space, but a space that I think really reflects the brand essence, what the brand stands for, but make up your mind, you'll see it later. Here's a time lapse of how this thing happened. A short video of showing the creation of the Cupra Garage, which was done in a remarkable 6 months' time. Remarkable building project. I think the fastest one ever in the history of anything ever that's ever been built at SEAT. An incredible achievement that shows how we can challenge the traditional ways. Getting this done in 6 months is remarkable, and I have to congratulate Antonino Labate, who led this project, for being so brave, as you will see later, but also for getting the thing done on time to allow us to open it for our second anniversary. And ladies and gentlemen, the Cupra dream will continue, as we have shown tonight. The dream is becoming more and more reality. The Cupra Leon, the Cupra Formentor that you will see very, very shortly. All of our partnerships around the world of sport, fashion, lifestyle and racing, all these dreams will take the brand to a higher level. But because we at Cupra would never be satisfied with what already we've achieved, we need to dream bigger and take Cupra to a fully electric era. And this is a dream we're all fighting for at Cupra, the Cupra Tavascan. And for me, there's no better proof that if we can dream it, we can do it, we can create it. So, Christian, that's it from my side. Presentation's coming to an end. It's been a great pleasure to have you here on this very, very special night for us. And Christian will now explain how the event will continue.
So, thank you, Wayne. You have given everything, really. When I'm thinking of the number of interviews you still have after, you will end up knackered tonight. In fairness, congratulations for the great achievements of these 2 years with the brand. And still a lot of novelties tonight. I know you're a bit frustrated that you couldn't show the Formentor tonight, but We need to keep something for Geneva. So you have already shown a lot. So. Now, a few logistic points as usual. As usual, you have found the USB stick on your seat with photographs and the full press kit. We have, as usual, the photo service, and if you need any help of any expert, please refer to your press manager. So, now I'm going to ask also Carsten to join us on stage, because we're going to move to the classical photo call. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to move to the Cupra garage, actually. for dinner, and you might have still one or two surprises in between. So for me, thank you very much. In the name of Cupra, thank you very much. And enjoy the evening with us. And now I'm calling the photographers, if you want to come here for the photo call. So Wayne and Karsten, if you want to get to the car for the photography. Thank you, and have a good evening.